In the early 60s, French New Wave directors balanced structure with spontaneous decisions. And the Danish actress Anna Karina was pivotal to the movement as she was both raw, yet still in harmony with the creative vibe. Alongside Jean-Luc Godard, she produced some of La Nouvelle Vague's most iconic moments. And, despite the chiaroscuro nature of their relationship, full of ups and downs, they managed to change cinema forever. Not long after Karina and Godard formed a professional and personal relationship, they made cameos in Agnès Varda's Cléo de Saint-Cassé. And while their up-and-down relationship has been well-documented over the years, their chemistry, at this point, is more than obvious. Like any great drama, there's darkness and revelatory moments, driven by Karina's obvious star power. And that charisma is most evident in Karina's breakout role, A Woman is a Woman, a film that not only introduced Karina to European audiences, but showed off her multifaceted skill set. She's far more than just a pretty face, far more than just a supporting player. And just like that, the Karina Godard connection transformed outhouse cinema.
Je dis toujours oui. Quand on me dit viens chérie, car avec les garçons, faut jamais faire de.
If Karina was endearing and relatable in A Woman is a Woman, she operated on an entirely different level in Vivre Sa Vie, playing a Parisian woman struggling to get by while seeking emotional and financial stability. As this famous dance sequence conveys, sometimes you just gotta let go, and Karina makes the most of the moment, as even the best directors, like Godard, can only do so much when asking the performer to let loose. Then again, Vivre Sa Vie is where life seemingly influenced cinema, and vice versa, for both parties involved. Clearly, Godard realized that he had something special with Karina, and it's that understanding that makes this collaboration so intriguing. Before Vivre Sa Vie, and before A Woman is a Woman, there was Le Petit Soldat, the film that essentially united Godard and Karina. In this particular sequence, both the male and female characters attempt to find common ground under difficult circumstances, and the energy is representative of that contagious new wave vibe. They're onto something special, or so it seems.
Oui. Bien sûr.
For those unfamiliar with Karina, look no further than Pierrot Le Fou to understand the totality of her influence over Godard.
Oui. Bien sûr.
And how she consistently conveys conflicting emotions, all the while continuing a bumpy creative narrative with her director. Karina's more than just a European star. She's the quintessential female icon of a transformative cinematic movement, a far more complex version of the oh-so-quirky manic pixie dream girl that appeals to so many modern actresses, many of whom inadvertently capitalize on style over substance. Approximately 60 years after the French New Wave unofficially began, I often find myself wondering how Karina and company made it all work, above the sacrifices they made in the name of cinema. And, like so many others, I'm in awe of Karina's accomplishments and how she influenced not only the entire movement, but one of cinema's most iconic directors. I think about how Karina and Godard found common ground when life and cinema became one, and how exciting it must have been during that first feature collaboration. Karina's clearly vulnerable yet focused, clearly willing to compromise to create something special.